Welcome to my review of Unfriended. Unfriended is directed by Leo Gabriel. It stars a bunch of talented actors and actresses. The premise of this movie follows the story of a group of friends who, by chance, they log on to Skype to have a conversation, and it so happens to be on the anniversary that one of their friends ends up passing after committing suicide. And the reason why she commits suicide is because a video ends up surfing online of something that happened to her. She gets extremely embarrassed by this said video that she ends up committing suicide. It's basically just kind of like, you know, the whole idea of like online bullying and stuff like that and how that has affected people in reality when it comes to their own self-esteem to the point that they feel like their self-worth is nothing. So they end up, you know, taking their own lives because of it. So this movie is basically about that, and it's a mixture of a horror movie. So it's taking something that has actually really has happened, and they're then taking it and making it into a movie. Now, people can, you know, look at this and see it as something, you know, taking something so serious and trying to make it into something entertaining, or you can watch this movie and see how that type of behavior does affect other people to the point that it goes as far as for them to want to commit suicide. So, you know, people will have different views on that, but I'm going to just strictly speak of this as a horror movie and a movie made for entertainment purposes and not really dive into the other aspects of that part of the movie. Now, going into this movie, I really went in pretty blindly. I did not watch any trailers for it or anything like that, so I really did not know much of the story besides that it took place on like social media and it was about a girl committing suicide and some kind of ghost or something that was like haunting these kids through the social media that they were on or something to that effect. Basically, I just went into it blindly. I think that's the best way you can go into this movie. It's like, do not watch any TV spots, do not watch any trailers, do not read the synopsis on it. Just go into this movie not knowing what it is and then watch it. Because I feel like if you go into it like that, you will enjoy it a lot more. Because everybody I was with really did not know much of what the movie was about. And we all pretty much enjoyed the movie. I personally really enjoyed the movie because it was relatable in a lot of ways. I mean, if you ever use Facebook, Skype plays a big part in this movie. Any of those, you know, Facebook, Skype, iMessenger, anything like that, it's a very big product placement for Apple computers, MacBooks, because basically the girl is running on that. So there's a lot of moments where she's using iTunes, she's using iChat, Google Chrome, there's a lot of Google stuff placement. It's just basically, if you've ever been on a computer, you can relate to what's taking place on screen. And that's what I really liked about the movie, because there are certain aspects of it, especially when they were on Skype, that I was like, I've been in a situation like that, where they're, you know, trying to deal with some kind of like problem with the program not working. So what people do, they end up logging all off, and then having somebody else host the chat, because maybe that'll fix the issue. And you see a part in the movie that's like that, and that was very relatable because I've experienced that through Skype. As for the story in the movie, I thought it was pretty clever because I liked the way the story was told and the things that happened. I wouldn't say this movie is really scary, even though there were certain points in the movie that I found myself like doing that hand cover where you're like looking through your fingers and you're like not sure whether you should look or not. Like I did that at least twice in the movie just because I really don't like jump scares. But other than that, there wasn't really any big like real scares. I think the movie, I would you know, label this movie more of a thriller than a horror film. And I would also classify it as a mystery because you're trying to figure out who did what and who's responsible for this. So I would say this movie is really fun if you go in not knowing much about it and if you go with a big group of friends, because you know afterwards you'll start talking about it. But I'm gonna say if you're like really nerdy, like when it comes to like how the computer works and just like operating systems and just programs in general and how, you know, Skype works or Facebook, there's going to be little things here and there to be like, oh, that doesn't make any sense. If you go into this movie just expecting fun and just expecting a thriller type of mysterious story type of deal, you'll enjoy it. It's a fun movie in that sense. So don't go in expecting a lot, and you might come out of it enjoying it a lot more than you thought. So that is my review of Unfriended. Thank you for watching, and if you haven't already, please subscribe.
Cinderella is directed by Kenneth Branagh. It stars Lily James, Kate Blanchett, Richard Madden, and a bunch of other very talented actors and actresses. Now, the premise of this movie follows the story of Ella, who is played by Lily James. Her father ends up passing away while he's on a trip to France, and because of this, she ends up getting stuck with her stepmother, is played by Kate Blanchett. And she is absolutely mean to her. Her stepsisters are mean to her. They treat her like a slave. If you've seen one Cinderella movie,